My name is Lance Osborne, and my story is one of living slow. I didn't come to this living slow with help from the latest self-help time management book, The Great Planner, with the gratitude journal in the back, or an app or podcast, or even an executive coach. I didn't come to a life of living slow by finally catching up. I came to a life of living slow by finally giving up. Surrender. Complete surrender to a almighty, all-powerful, all-loving and forgiving God. As He continued to pursue me and put me in a position where truth had come to call, I could no longer live fast enough to outrun all the things that my sin had created. I didn't know what to do. I cried out in despair, God, what do I do? And clearly, not audibly, but clearly, I heard, trust me. That began my journey of first repenting and then surrendering to the truth, which meant telling all of the sin and the secrets and the lies and the deception that it kept it, to keep it going. And that was very destructive, very hurtful for those that I love the most. You see, I believe we need this certainty, and we believe that we can control that certainty, that it is our own efforts that we can create this certain place for us. And I believe that real trust comes from surrendering certainty to living with a sense of uncertainty and that it's going to be okay. You see, when I needed certainty, I believed that it was me that could create that me that could control that. You see, I had the priorities right. I stated them right. You know, God, wife, kids, family, others, me. And then quickly my calendar would be back to me, 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 family, me. In the book, The Ruthless Elimination of Hurry, the author calls himself an apprentice of Jesus, and he tries to follow the ways of Jesus, not just the teaching of Jesus. And he uses the story of when they came to Jesus to come to Lazarus, that his friend was sick. And he points out that it wasn't just his friend, it was his best friend. And he wasn't just sick, he was dying. And you would think that Jesus would drop everything, and in his sense of urgency, he would run to Lazarus' side. But that's not the story. The story that he stayed where he was for 2 days and then he went. You know how the story goes from there. You see, I believe that that is the pace that I'm called to live. Interruptible, easy, without haste, and without hurry, so that I can be truly in this culture, but be counter to culture. There's probably nothing more counterculture today than living slow, living with patience. I'd held this identity in me and all the things that were important to me, and I had to completely surrender to my identity in Christ. I wish I could tell you that surrender and serenity and identity in Christ happened in a day. What I have to tell you is it's still happening today. See, identity in Christ means that I need to be with Jesus. I want to be more like Jesus, and I want to do what Jesus would do if He was me. And to do that, I have to go slow. I have to take the time and time with Jesus. That's prayer and meditation and time that I'm not even talking and I'm not even reading. I'm just sitting in the presence of and in the love of. I believe living slow gives me the opportunity to answer questions about how I came to this patience and point others to a life of slow. to be with Jesus, to be more like Jesus, and to do the things that Jesus would do if He were with me. My name is Lance Osborne. My story is one of living slow.